A very important game for SK Gaming against one of their hardest opponents, Gambit Gaming, started with First Blood in bot lane. A brilliant stun on the wall by Candy Pander's Vayne secured a kill on Darien, and a second one followed immediately in top lane.
Of damage. Darien pushed against the wall, flashing from Candy Panda. The burn from the ignite is going to be enough, and it is the kill there for Nif, picking up first blood for SK Gaming, just what the doctor ordered.
Beautiful stuff right there. Pulling ignite into a two-on-one lane allows you that extra kill potential right there. It's always a bait. Do you go exhaust? Do you go ignite? But uh-oh, Darker.
Darker's in a lot of trouble here. Knockup comes in. Hercubot's going to secure that one. Are they going to go for Genja? Nope, not quite yet. And there's a brilliant statistic from Nif. Number one kill participation in the EU LCS right now.
It's still a really rough lane because the two-on-one fight works so well. Flay, Thresh Hook into Condemn into constant damage output works.
Alex going in here on towards Ocelot. He's going to get knocked up as Hercubot is there. Flash has been burnt all around as Diamond comes in. It's Alex, though, that is able to get that kill. The question is, how can they finish off? There's the Flay back. Nif picks up his second. Diamond in all kinds of trouble. He gets knocked up from that one. There's a Lantern to give Hercubot the shield. Flash is coming in. Can they finish this one off? He's a tough little sucker to get a hold of, and Hercubot goes underneath the turret, and in the end, Diamond's done enough to at least get one kill back from that.
The first of many excellent hooks by Nif granted another kill for his lane partner, Candy Panda.
Well, Seeker's Armgun is done for Ocelot, but he's taking big blasts of damage as a hook. He's going to land here on towards Darker. Flay actually not knocking him like they wanted, but Candy Panda got the damage now with that double Doran's Blade in there, and that's another kill coming down for SK. The danger is as well, once that Vayne starts picking up the kills later on, he's going to be a beast as Diamond steals away the blue. He also took his blue, don't forget, just before.
Yes. Nif unfortunately made me a liar, landing a hook onto Sona. Okay, that'll get you some kills, so grats on that one, but it is thing to be afraid of here.
Oh, Alex going in there. He's already used the shadow as he goes backwards on towards Ocelot here. Alex going very low. Actually, will be finished off. And the death mark, not enough to finish off Ocelot, who right now he's got one kill to his name, that one there. The two assists as well. And it's just about survival and hoping that Hercubot's in the right place at the right time when that happens.
Diamond does know he needs to counter gank this. He assumes from the flash being down the low level of Sona that there's likely to be a gank around. But the fact that it hasn't happened yet makes him, well, maybe not so much. Maybe I'll go towards mid. Maybe I'll look something else. But there's the catch.
There's the hook on towards Darker. There comes the Cardless ulti as well. And Ocelot picks up that kill at the end there. And again, just pure coordination. Hercubot even managed to get in there in the bottom. Didn't quite get himself an assist for it, though.
An amazing play from Kevin under his turret gave two kills to Ocelot's Karthus.
Survive, but if the positioning is good enough for Gambit, they can take him down.
Oh, you see, bit of damage being exchanged here. Kevin, he's going to be going into this one. Here we go. Ultimate comes out from Diamond. Are we going to see him put down the unstoppable force from this one? He's holding on, and there is the flash away. Darien's right underneath the turret. Where is the unstoppable force? Not really doing as much as he wants to. And here comes Ocelot from this one. He's going to get himself two kills there. Evelyn was underneath the turret. An incredible stuff that I can't believe that just happened.
He flashed it.
I didn't even notice that he'd done that. It was too fast for my eyes even. And then Ocelot turning things around for a double kill at the end. Fantastic. Brilliant. Amazing. And there's Diamond. He's going to be coming straight through a ward. And Kevin spots that one happening. And he's not going to fall for anything this time. Or maybe he's trying to lure him in for those two kills again as we see the wall of pain going down on towards Alex. The exhaust is down here as well. He's going to put the pressure down and he might be able to turn it around here on towards Turkey. But Darker manages to secure the kill. And then in similar fashion to that top lane, the kill turnaround right under the turret coming out of Gambit. I think they're going to be sold out at some point during this game. Hercubot comes down to cover this bottom turret. Alex actually going at him under the turret here. That death mark coming in. And Alex going to pick up the kill. And right there is the danger of Zed.
Yes.
With a perfect timing on his ultimate, Alex Itch managed to secure two kills for his team.
Don't know the playstyle properly. This isn't like a, I'm trying to think of like, you know, Lemon Dogs of old or old CLG EU where they're just like, yeah, we really don't want to push. We just know we will win at 65 minutes in. That's not really SK's thought process. However, Candy Panda, he's super surrounded.
He's going to have Evelyn coming in. There's Alex Itch going to go into him. The Condemn coming down. Blade of the Ruin King going to be using. Good damage coming out of Candy Panda, but here comes Diamond. He's going to chase off Alex Itch. Is he going to die to this one? His timing was perfectly there between the Requiem. He got invulnerable for that split second. What timing coming out? And that will be a 2-for-1, where in all rights, Alex should be a dead man.
improves his damage so he can finally try to outscale the health from the Rod of Ages and the armor from the Zonya's Hourglass.
Oh, this could be dangerous for him, though. They know that he's going to be here from this one. As Wall of Pain goes down, he's going to be in all kinds of trouble from this. There are four men there from SK Gaming. Herculebot in the end picks up the kill, and that's all about vision there.
The first team fight of the game ended with 3-0 for SK, but the next one turned out to be much closer.
Candy Panda gonna try and come around the side, but it's a trap. Zed's waiting there in the brushes, and Kevin here pushing up on towards Darien, who's just used the active on that Rando in Zoman as he starts to go in towards Candy Panda. He's gonna stun up Alex Hitch. There is a lantern. He goes flying back. Now Alex has to flash away from that one. Meanwhile, Diamond going down. Darker going down. Darien's caught inside the box. He's a dead man as well, or is he? Flashes away there, but Kevin's chasing. That's a double kill for the Crocodile. Just whether they can actually drive it over the finish line, as they are going to get the hook here on towards Alex Hitch. Herculebot going to come press it.
Right. There we go.
A little bit slow to react to that one there. Requiem is not going to finish off Alex. He actually dodged it again there, but he's going to die anyway. Darker's going to die. Now Darien's writing in there on top of them. Let's see if he can actually finish off Ocelot with this one. Should be able to now that Diamond's actually coming across from this one. And there is the finisher shut down as well for Diamond.
They're pushing forward. And the thing to remember is they do technically outscale. So as long as they don't make any mistakes, there's six items.
Brilliant move from Candy Panda coming from the side, secured a triple kill for Kevin and the overall ace for SK.
There, as we are going to see the Unstoppable Force coming down on towards Ocelot. He's in all kinds of trouble, has to use his Zonyas. That'll save him from a little bit of damage, but Alex Hitch will finish that one off as Kevin now diving in there. Requiem going to come down. Diamond's at half HP. He will Zonyas away from that one. Alex going half back into the fight. Here comes Candy Panda from the side, though. Barrier used by Genja. Candy Panda's not being focused fast enough here. They're going to clean house. It's a double kill for Kevin, a triple kill for Kevin. Can they finish off here onto Diamond? Darien, they almost certainly can, as a knockup comes down. Darien running for dear life. He's going to get finished off. It's the ace from SK Gaming. Just as I said, what have they done with it? Nif got caught out of position, and SK turned it around.
Enough to control that and potentially swing the game around.
The red buff pickup coming in. We're going to see a bit of a battle for the pink wards there. Is Nif actually catching Darien here? And they might actually go for him. The box goes down. Crescendo comes across. Herculebot, though, is on towards Darker. He flashes away. And look at that. Darien using the Unstoppable Force to get away. But he's going to be finished off by Ocelot. And this surely opens the floodgates up now to SK Gaming. They've got two of them down. Alex Hitch is going to be in trouble. He's forced to flash away from that one as Candy Panda gets locked up, hit with a piercing arrow. But this should be a turret coming in there, as the chain of corruption spreading through the SK team. They've got two kills, but they're very, very low from this one. That shield helping out. Alex and Diamond actually chasing in, as Alex is going to go right on top of them, but SK turn around. Loads of damage coming out there. Alex is going to go down. Now they can maybe get in onto Diamond. Here comes a Requiem. That'll be enough to finish off Diamond if he didn't. Zonya's at the perfect time for him. Only a matter of time before he does go down, though, and SK should now be able to take the turret with only Genja left alive.
All from Nif making that happen. They've got the damage output that if they can force the engage, right? If they can actually make these battles start, they're in great shape.
Oh, Darien actually, he's right back in there. He's teleported onto the Warden. Well, I'm not sure that he's going to be able to survive this one either. I mean, he's pretty damn tanky. It took five of them to take him down. Herculebot being hit there by the piercing arrow, but they do see a target to the likes of Darker and Genja, and Darker going to get absolutely shredded. Darien's a dead man for the second time in as many minutes from that one as he respawns back in. Baron is available, but look at that. SK Gaming, no risks.
With the Baron buff on their side, SK piled up in Gambit's base, took down three of their members, and finished the game in their favor.
Crescendo is a beautiful one. It goes on to three of them. Darker going very, very low. Diamond going to be forced to use that Zonya's Hourglass, and as he comes up, Candy Panda rips him to pieces. They're falling here. There's three men down to the no kill so far for Gambit. That inhibitor is dead, and they're going to go onto the bottom side, take the turret, and take inhibitor number two as well.
This is likely going to be enough for SK Gaming. They've got minions flooding into the base. They're trying to get the catch. They get the stun to Alex.
Wow, massive damage coming in there from Candy Panda as well. There's Guardian Angel still up for Alex and for Candy Panda here. As we are going to see Genja trying to piercing arrow them down from that. Those two GAs still alive, as we are going to see him going on towards Candy Panda. He gets knocked straight back away. GA still not popped, but SK are going in on towards the Nexus turret. The first one already gone. The second one doesn't stand a chance. Alex trying his best to come over from the side, but SK focusing down the Nexus. They're going to take out Gambit here.